Offset is an interesting formula, and it's one that can do so much more than meets the eye. Now, offset is a way of giving Excel an address to go to. So you start off by telling it how many rows to move, and then how many columns to move to get to its destination. Now, this destination can be a single house, like a single cell. It can be a street, like many cells in one row or one column, or it can also be like a town, like an area, a range in Excel. Now you might think, what on earth can this be useful for? Why would I ever need to use an address in my Excel files? In this example, I have months here and sales revenue here, and I want to get the average of the last 6 months. So obviously, one way of doing this is to use the average function and then highlight this like this. But now the problem is that this is a dynamic report. So every month, new data comes in for August. I put in the data here. To get this average of last 6 months to work properly, I have to drag this range down manually. And that's something I want to avoid. And the offset function is what helps me avoid this. To show you how we can do this, I'm going to teach you offset on its own as a first step. And as a second step, we're going to integrate it into the average function. The syntax of the offset function is that you always need a starting point, a reference. It's like before you start your walk, where are you going to start? You can pick any cell, but it should be close to the range that you want to end up in. So I'm going to pick this cell. And then how many rows do I want to move down? So let's say I want to move down one. How many columns do I want to move? I'm going to put zero here because I want to stay in this column. And the last two arguments are the height and the width. A 1, 1 means one cell. These last two, they can never be a 0, 0. At the minimum, they can be a 1, 1. If I wanted like these three, I would put 3, 1. And let's stick with 1, 1 first. And we get 100. So we start here, go down one, don't move columns, give us one cell, it's 100. If I would move down three, I get 130. If I move columns, if I actually put a minus one, so meaning from here, go here, I get my date back. Okay, I would just have to change the formatting. If I do a plus one, I get a zero, because where am I? I'm here. Let's put a two. See, I'm here. That's basically what offset does. If I did want a range, I'm going to put this column back to zero. And instead of having a one for height, I'm going to put three for height. I get value. Because what it does is that I'm starting here, move down three, one, two, three, and then give me these three cells. So it can't actually put these three cells in one cell. Now, whenever you use offset in a way that these last two arguments are ranges, they're not just returning one cell, but a range of cells, you need to wrap your offset formula in a formula that can handle ranges. What would that formula be? For example, the average formula, or the sum formula, or the count formula, anything that can handle ranges. So in this case, we're going to use the average formula. 108, so that would be the average of these three. Now we're going to expand on this formula to get the last 6 months. There are different ways of writing this. One way is that
You can first see what's the last cell in here by using the count function, and then come down to the last cell, and then as your height, you kind of go back and highlight the -6 or the 6 rows before this. Or you basically find your last cell, and then you go back to the 6th row, and your height is then +6. Don't get confused by this. I'm just going to show you as a first step. The simpler one is the one I prefer, and then the other way as well. Later on, you can also play around with it and see how they work. As a first method of writing this, now I start here, right? I need to know how much should I move down. I can do this by counting the number of filled cells that I have here. I can use here the count function or the count A function. Count A basically counts even if it's text. The count alone only counts if these are values. In this case, it doesn't matter, count or count A. And then I highlight this. And the important thing is that you highlight more than what you have, because in the future, I will have data here. So I need to take them into account as well. The result of this count A function is going to be 7. It's going to tell me move down 7, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I end up here. How many columns to move? Nothing. I want to stay in this column. And what's my height? That's where -6 comes in, because I want the average of the last 6 months. -6 will be this, from here to here. And 1 is that's my width. 113, let's check that. 113. So now when I add a new month to this, it's 127. 127. My range updates automatically. You can also check this by going to formulas, evaluate formula. I start off here, I go down 8, don't move any columns, -6, 1. So the final range that it's taking the average of is B6 to B11, which is this to this. The other way of writing this, like I mentioned before, I'll just show it to you, is average offset. Now we can start here in this case. The number of rows I want to go down is, I'm going to do a count A again, or let's do a count now. Highlight this. And I do a -6. So basically, the result of the count formula in this case now is going to be 8, because I added another month, -6, it's 2. It only moves down 2 rows, 1, 2. For my columns, it's 0, I don't want to move any columns, and for my height, I don't do a -6, but instead a +6, and my width is 1. I get that, which is the last 6 months. Two different ways of writing this, you come to the same conclusion. Now, what if your data was organized in this way instead? So we want the average of the last 6 months, but we have them in rows. We do the same thing. I start off with the average function, then the offset, and my reference is here. Let's say I want to start off here. How many rows do I want to move? Nothing. So that's 0. How many columns do I want to move? Again, that depends on how many columns I have numbers in. I'm going to use the count function or the count A function, and I'm going to highlight until where I think I'm going to have numbers in. Now for height, it should just be 1 now. But for width, I need from here to go here, I need it to be minus 6. Okay, so it was just the other way around, but it does the same thing of getting the average of the last 6 months. So if I add data here for August, I get 127. So just be creative and practice this in all directions until you get the hang of it. Now, another good example on this is if you have your months and your sales revenue, and you have a report where you always want the average of the next 3 months based on a selection. Let's say you've included a drop down here where you can select your month from this list and you want to get the average of the next 3 months. We're going to do the same thing. So we're going to use the average function together with offset. As a reference point, that can be fixed. We can always start off from here. And then how many rows do we want to go down? Well, in this case, we want to move down until we get to 414, which is here. We want to move down this much. Which function can I use that gives me back a number? The match function, because that gives us the position of 90 in this list. And the result would be the fourth position, so I know I need to move down 4 rows. First, I need to have the lookup value. I'm looking this up in here. I want a perfect match, never forget that. That's how many rows I want to move down, because the result of this is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now for the columns, I don't want to move any columns. I want to stay in this column. So that's going to be 0. For the height, that depends on my question. If I wanted to include this month as well, I would put a 3. And a 1 for my width. 102. So let's check that. That's this one. These three, it's 102. If I didn't want to include this month, I just have to add a plus 1 to my match. So I can say find this, then go down 1 extra. So that would be the 3 months after this. So that would be these. This is purely dynamic, so if I would go down and select December 2014, I get 232. In this case, I'm doing the next 3 months, the 3 months after this. It would be these three, 232. That's how you can use the average function, the offset function, the match function, all together to create this dynamic effect.
A word of caution is that offset is a volatile formula, which means it calculates every time you make a move in Excel. Now, to be honest with you, in the files that I've used offset in, I've never experienced my files to become slow because of me using offset. But I also don't overdose on them, so I also recommend that you don't overuse them.